My name is Jen Kay, and I'm a professor at the University of Colorado. In this video, we introduce feedbacks that are important in the Arctic climate system.
Hi, I'm Ariel, and I'm a graduate student working with Jen. I study Arctic clouds and sea ice. I'm here in Churchill, Manitoba, which is a really cool little town on the coast of the Hudson Bay.
Polar bears spend time nearby while they wait for sea ice to refreeze each year in the fall. In fact, during late fall, the 900 human Churchill residents share the tundra with about 900 polar bears. Now talk about neighbors you'd want to get along with. The nearby Hudson Bay has sea ice on it during winter. Sea ice is bright, white, and reflective. The high reflectivity of sea ice means that it has a high albedo, which is simply a measure of the reflectivity of a surface. For example, if a surface reflects 50% of the sunlight that hits it, then that surface has an albedo of 0.5. Albedo ranges from 0, which is reflecting no incoming sunlight, to 1, reflecting all incoming sunlight. The albedo of sea ice is about 0.6 on average. Snow on top of the sea ice increases the albedo to 0.9. A lot of sunlight can get reflected from fresh snow, which is why you wear sunscreen and goggles when you ski or snowboard in Colorado. Snow and sea ice maintain a pretty high albedo for the Arctic surface, but that albedo changes as snow and sea ice cover change. Every year in the Arctic, snow and sea ice start melting in the spring and continue melting through the early fall. When sea ice melts completely, the dark ocean is exposed. Since the ocean underneath is very dark, it has a really low albedo, 0.06. The ocean only reflects away about 6% of incoming sunlight, so it absorbs a lot of energy from the sun. When the surface ocean absorbs energy, it warms and more sea ice melts. As more sea ice melts, more dark water is exposed. More open water, in turn, leads to more sunlight being absorbed by the ocean. As the surface ocean absorbs more sunlight, more sea ice melts, and you get the picture. This whole process is called the surface albedo feedback.
Feedbacks are a key concept to understand in the climate system. Feedbacks can be positive and negative. Let's say the climate system is warming. A positive feedback occurs when factors further increase that warming. A negative feedback, on the other hand, occurs when factors reduce that warming. We are particularly interested in Arctic feedbacks because over the last 3 decades, the Arctic has warmed 3 times more than the global mean. The evolution of the Arctic climate system is influenced by many positive and negative feedbacks. The surface albedo feedback is a positive feedback that further increases Arctic warming and sea ice loss.
What are the negative feedbacks in the Arctic? Specifically, is there some sort of negative feedback that could slow down sea ice loss? To talk about a negative feedback in the Arctic, we're going to move up into the atmosphere and talk about clouds. Because clouds are bright, they have a similar albedo to snow-covered sea ice, about 0.8 for clouds, and remember, about 0.9 for snow-covered ice. In the summer, when the surface albedo feedback is strongest because the days are long and there's lots of sunlight, forming clouds over newly open ocean could replace one lost bright surface, the sea ice, with another, clouds, thereby maintaining a fairly high albedo for the Arctic surface and reflecting sunlight away from the ocean. However, in my research, I found no evidence that Arctic clouds form in response to sea ice loss during the summer. Summer clouds can't be relied upon to reduce the strength of the surface albedo feedback and slow the rate of Arctic sea ice loss.
The Arctic climate system is a complicated place with many positive and negative feedbacks. We learned about the importance of feedbacks, the positive surface albedo feedback that we have evidence for, and a potential negative feedback we aren't seeing evidence for. The Arctic has warmed and is projected to warm a lot more because of its particularly strong positive feedbacks.